वेलकम ऑल टुडेज टॉप ब्रेकिंग न्यूज़ विद गीतांजलि फ्रॉम बाइन टाइम्स। फ्लाइट ऑपरेशन हिट आफ्टर फायर टेंडर स्किड्स ऑफ तिरुपति एयरपोर्ट रनवे। अ फायर टेंडर ऑफ द तिरुपति इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट विच वॉज ऑन अ रूटीन चेक ऑफ द रनवे टिल्टेड टू वन साइड ऑन द रनवे ऑन संडे मॉर्निंग, फोर्सिंग द एयरपोर्ट अथॉरिटीज टू डाइवर्ट द मॉर्निंग फ्लाइट्स शेड्यूल्ड। द रनवे वॉज क्लियर फॉर लैंडिंग एंड टेक ऑफ आफ्टर 2.5 hours. Around 9:30 a.m., the fire tender was on a routine check of the runway when it skidded and tilted. According to Tirupati Airport Director S. Suresh, they immediately alerted the pilot of a scheduled flight from Bengaluru about the mishap on the runway, and the Indigo flight went back to Bengaluru. In 2.5 hours, the fire tender was cleared from the runway and the operations resumed. The flight which returned to Bengaluru landed at Tirupati after clearance was given, Suresh said. More COVID hospitals to be engaged in Srikakulam. As the first and second level COVID hospitals are packed with patients, the district administration is readying GMR Care Hospital in Rajam for the treatment of coronavirus patients. The authorities are also mulling to convert the district hospital in Tekali into a COVID hospital, while GMS and Srikakulam Government General Hospital are assigned as first and second level hospitals. The GMR hospital is put in the third level. Meanwhile, of the 2,564 cases recorded so far in the district, over 70% were reported this month alone, as Srikakulam has been witnessing a daily spike of minimum 100 infections lately. To meet the rising demand, two COVID care centers were also launched where mild and moderate cases are being treated. TIDCO Urban Housing Complex at Putraniwalasa and Shivani Engineering College at Echerla with 500 and 200 beds respectively were being used for the purpose. Joint Collector Sumit Kumar inspected the GMR hospital 2 days ago. There are 830 beds in GMS hospital and 250 more in the GGH. Almost all beds are filled at present, said District COVID Nodal Officer Dr. B. Jagannatha Rao. Chandrababu Naidu urges Governor to protect people's rights. TDP Supremo and Chandrababu Naidu has appealed to Governor Biswa Bhushan Harichandan to intervene and restore the fundamental rights to people of Andhra Pradesh as guaranteed in the Indian Constitution. Naidu termed it a historical necessity on the part of the Governor to intervene in the matter, as a spate of unlawful arrest of different sections of people have been continuing in the state ever since the YSRC assumed power in 2019. Addressed to the government, the TDP chief said, two youths belonging to Prakasam district were wrongfully arrested and tortured by police in gross violation of Article 19 of the Constitution. The YSRC government was infringing on the freedom of speech and expression of people. The ruling YSRC, in connivance with a section of police, is targeting the public to suppress all forms of dissent. The people who expressed their dissent against the government's failures on social media came under attack by police, he said. SVIMS extends suspension of OP services till July 25. Sri Venkateswara Institute of Medical Sciences, SVIMS, has extended the suspension of outpatient OP services till July 25. According to SVIMS Director cum Vice Chancellor Dr. B. Vyangama, 40 employees including medical, paramedical, administrative, sanitation and other departments tested positive for COVID-19 till last week. Initially, the hospital management had decided to suspend OP services from July 14 to 18. However, the steady rise in COVID-19 cases among staff has forced the management to revise its decisions and extend the suspension of OP services for 7 more days, starting from Saturday, Vangamma said. After July 25, the hospital management will hold discussions with higher-ups of the state medical and health department before taking a decision on reopening the outpatient services. Fight for power, villagers tie up electricity department staff in Telangana. Fed up with the frequent power cuts and apathy of officials, residents of a Sangareddy village tied up two bill collectors and a lineman of the electricity department at the panchayat office and refused to release them until their problems were resolved. As tempers flared and a heated argument broke out, the police managed to pacify the villagers, released the staff and arrested five persons on charges of assault. Like every month, bill collectors Isaiah and Ravi visited Muslapur village at Aladurgam Mandal in the district around 8:30 a.m. to collect electricity bills. The furious villagers cornered them over the frequent power cuts and how the officials did not care to address their repeated complaints regarding the same. They also told the bill collectors about a recent short circuit in a residential area which burned many people's television sets, refrigerators and other appliances. The staff told them that power supply is not under their purview and that they should take their problems to a lineman or the AEM. The villagers said they received this reply every month. They forced the bill collectors to stay put until a senior official reached the spot. New cases, 6 deaths in Telangana. Telangana recorded 1,284 COVID cases, taking the statewide tally to 43,780 on Saturday. As many as 14,883 tests were done, a substantial number of which were rapid antigen tests known to record false negatives. 6 people succumbed to the virus. The state's positivity rate stands at 17%, with 4,945 tests conducted per million. Most cases were reported in the GHMC 667. Meanwhile, Sangareddy saw 86 cases, Karimnagar 58 and Nalgonda 46. The medical bulletin also stated that 6 labs have now been equipped with superior CBNAAT machines which can conduct RT-PCR tests faster. They are located in Adilabad, Nizamabad, Suryapet, Gadwal, Kothagudem and Karimnagar. In government facilities, 2,926 ICU and 1,318 oxygen beds are available. As for Osmania General Hospital, the Chief Minister would conduct a meeting on what could be done to alleviate patient woes caused by the dilapidated structure. Panchayat Raj official diverts over Rs 6 crore COVID funds in Telangana suspended. In a first, COVID-19 funds of 6.04 crore allotted for the manufacture of masks, sanitizers, PPE kits and hand wash solutions were used for making sanitary napkins and other work unrelated to the pandemic. Following the diversion which came to the light on Saturday, the Deputy Chief Executive Officer of the Panchayat Raj and Rural Development Department, P. Malaya, who was on deputation as the Director of the Society for Elimination of Rural Poverty, SERP, has been placed under suspension. The Rs 6.04 crore Community Investment Funds CIF were released by the SERP under the National Rural Livelihood Mission NRLM for COVID-19 activities. The amount was given to the District Rural Development Agencies DRDAs in Telangana but was diverted for other non-COVID activities, according to a GO issued by Panchayat Raj Secretary Sandeep Kumar Sultania. Uttam asked KCR to scale up testing and treatment. TPCC President and Nalgonda MP N. Uttam Kumar Reddy has alleged that the negligence of Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao in handling COVID pandemic in the state was nothing short of cruelty against humanity as it killed hundreds. Addressing the party cadre on Facebook as a part of Speak Up Telangana campaign organized by TPCC COVID-19 Task Force Committee on Saturday, Uttam said that CM had adopted a non-serious approach in handling COVID-19 situation right from the beginning. It seems that KCR still believes that COVID-19 can be treated with a paracetamol and that was the reason why he made no serious efforts to follow the World Health Organization's norms of trace, test and treat the COVID-19 patients, he said. Uttam reiterated the demand that COVID-19 treatment he brought under Arogya Shri scheme. He said, COVID-19 treatment should be totally free for all BPL families. Meanwhile, TPCC Working President and Malkajgiri MP A. Remant Reddy demanded that the demolition of a secretariat should undergo a supervision of Archaeological Department and NMDC. Ensure supply of COVID-19 drugs, Telangana Health Minister Yettala Rajender tells dealers. To ensure there is no shortage of basic drugs required in COVID-19 treatment, Health Minister Yettala Rajender held a meeting with pharma dealers and asked them to ensure supply across the state. Reiterating the Chief Minister's directions, the Minister said that black marketing must not be allowed and free flow of medicines must be ensured from village to hospital level. Some of these drugs used in COVID-19 treatment, azithromycin, doxycycline, dexamethasone, methylprednisolone, vitamin D, vitamin C and zinc. Apart from this, the Chief Minister has held discussions with the management of Hetero Drugs Pharmaceuticals who are involved in the production of Remdesivir drug, which is commonly coming handy to reduce viral load in critical patients, said the minister. The minister also asked authorities to ensure that both expensive and inexpensive medicines were stocked alike at all government hospitals. Kinki Sari Padenta Queen Piche Ki Chedam. After the big announcement from Prabhas 21 makers about Deepika Padukone to romance Prabhas, director Nagashwin comes up with interesting tweet. Prabhas fans going crazy after this tweet. Nagashwin tweeted that Kinki Sari Padenta Queen Kavali Kadamari Chala Aluchinji Tisukunna decision ED Piche Ki Chedam. Vaijayanti Movies is making the film prestigiously and they are making sure this film is going to be a memorable one for everyone associated with it. Built to be a sci-fi, Prabhas will begin shoot of the film after wrapping up his ongoing flick Radhe Shyam, being directed by Radha Krishna Kumar. With this, we conclude with our today's news headlines. For more such latest news and updates, like, share and subscribe by N Times.